Isang isyu na naman ang pag-usapan sa pangunguna ni Senator Pia Cayetano patungkol sa mga lumalabas na sakit patungkol sa paggamit ng vape ng mga tao.
Question. But I'm posing it to you because that is the reality. Yes, I know TB is important. In fact, I have loved ones who have TB because sabi nga nila almost every Filipino is exposed to TB. So I know, and I know how complicated it can get because during the time of COVID, yung mga may TV, mas may tama. So I know, wala tayong issue dyan.
Dahil di umano sa pagbebenta ng mga vape sa lansangan, madaming mga nahihikayat bumili at gumamit nito. Anya, pati mga kabataan ay biktima ng mga ganitong klaseng gamit at hindi alam na malaki pala ang magiging pinsala sa pangangatawan ng mga gumagamit. Halika at panoorin ang video na ito.
May mga grupo bang humahadlang sa pagsulong ng TV programs natin? Meron ba?
Wala naman, ma'am.
Wala naman. So, if you are the leader of a battle, saan kang battle pupunta? Doon sa may kalaban ka o doon sa walang kalaban? You don't have to answer that question. But I'm posing it to you because that is the reality. Yes, I know TB is important. In fact, I have loved ones who have TB because sabi nga nila, almost every Filipino is exposed to TB. So I know, and I know how complicated it can get because during the time of COVID, yung mga may TB, mas may tama. So I know, wala tayong issue dyan. Ang tanong ko lang is, may humahad lang ba? I'm happy for you. I congratulate you for the recognition. I'm happy when anyone in our country gets recognition because Filipinos are known to be hardworking and we're intelligent and we deserve the recognition. Pero saan kang laban kailangan, Secretary? Yun ang tanong. Okay? So I'll leave it at that. Let's proceed because I need you to decide what your priorities are because if you tell me that you've requested to be part and I do know your history as an anti-tobacco advocate, then I want to see if next year, paano ko may kasabay? Paano ko may polio? Ang tindi din ng polio. I'm very scared about the resurgence of polio, of measles. Paano kung doon ka pinatawag? I would like you there too. Those are also issues important to me as a mother, as a health advocate. But saan ka kailangan?
That's correct.
Anyway, I give you back the floor. Please proceed.
Thank you, Madam Chair, for that clarification. And I continue because when I came back, even after, although I attended the TB meeting, when I came back and I heard after the events in Panama, I immediately held a meeting with the chief of the PNP. And the purpose of the meeting was really to implement the vape law in which they lowered the age limit to 18. So I held a meeting with PNP and said, what is the PNP doing? And they promised, at that time it was still PNP Chief Acorda. So I had the high level meeting with him, with all his generals, to actually discuss the implementation of execution, because I was seeing kids as I drive around. I see kids in high school uniform with something hanging on their neck, and then they actually sift. So I said, these are not 18 years old. And our law specifically says, the vape products cannot be sold to 18 years old. So I was asking them to create an implementation of the law, and they gladly said they will actually. So my battles are there, ma'am. I still continue to make sure that what is made as a law and as a DOH secretary protect the health of our youth. So yun ang una kong ginawa. And then I also requested DFA, the next meeting, I would really like to see a health team that would attend the FCTC, because the FCTC is a health treaty, and the people that attend it are health experts and health experts and advocates of health. So I would like to see a Philippine delegation that actually are pro health, which is our mandate. So, and I would love to head a team like that. And you can understand also my frustration because I'm going to be head of delegation of a 34-man team, and more than half are from the industry. So,
but you also should have put on record your statements about it, Secretary, because as public officials, we will all be held accountable for our actions. Eh? So for your protection, each one of you, DTI, FDA, DOH, cover your tracks. This is I'm not scaring you, but it is a fact. If you don't cover your tracks and you become party to actions that endanger Filipinos, you could be... The law is very clear. You may be found negligent of your duty, and there are criminal repercussions. So that's me telling you that be careful, because the law is also very clear on what your mandates are. So anyway,
Thank you very much, ma'am.
Put it on record. If you have a problem with how things were organized, if you do not agree with that 30, you should say so. You should say that I'm happy to head this delegation of 6 people, of 8 people, and that the law does not allow. Are you aware, Mr. Secretary, of the prohibition on what is the word? I'm about to say fraternizing, no, with the tobacco industry, but what is the actual wording of the law? I'm sure memorized ni Dr. Julian. What is the word?
Interference.
What is the word?
Tobacco industry.
Can we read it? Somebody just take the floor and just put on the mic kasi sabay para tayong chorus. Memorize nyo lahat.
Dr. Marie Carly, yes. Ma'am. Unnecessary interactions with tobacco industry.
Necessary actions with the tobacco industry. That's what it is. Unnecessary. So pag necessary. So for example, what I was explaining to my team, they have to register. So if they will have to talk to the representatives of FDA and ask for clarification, what's the registration requirement? Okay naman yun eh, kasi kailangan naman nila malaman kung paano mag-register, di ba? Ngayon, kung sasama sa anniversary ng DOH o DTI, I don't think that's necessary. Kung sasama sa delegation, it's a health convention. Why are they there? They can give their position paper, they can submit their position paper. So you have to make a stand.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Yes, we actually did make a stand. We had several pre-meeting meetings with the DTI, Tobacco Authority, DFA in the DFA building. And we held several because we submitted our own statements and positions against tobacco in those meetings. Of course, there were some agreements, but there were also disagreements. And in fact, in those meetings, I clearly stated that we should not even speak if we have a disagreement between the members of the delegation.
Can you say that again, that statement?
Because what happened in the previous FCTC was we were given an ASTRAE award, not in this one, the previous one, that because there were statements that were vague from the Philippine delegation. There was pro and anti-tobacco statements being said at the same time. So in the meeting, in the preparations for Panama, I specifically stated we only declare things that we have consensus on. And those wherein we are arguing, industry is arguing with health, we will not make any official statement. And I think our SDES was able to actually handle that very well. Even my chief of staff, Undersecretary Lilibet, knew our stance. It's the health stand. Even the president knew I'm for the health stand of the Filipino people in this one.
On that note, Mr. Secretary, what happened was, and yun nga, it was a battle you were not physically present in, nagkanda delay ang resolution on the issue of testing and content of tobacco products. And there were all sorts of, not all sorts, but there were recommendations coming from the Philippine delegation, which basically led to the delay. And the delay is known to be a tobacco lobby tactic. If you're new to this, which you are not, but those new to it might not see it right away na, karapatan naman nila mag-propose ng expert group, working group, isang katutak na group. Yun nga yung point eh. In the world of tobacco lobby, the advocates for health know that it is a tactic. And you were not around to try to push it, no? With all due respect to the late Secretary Guevara, who I have a lot of respect for, he was explaining how he did not see right away that this resulted in non-action on the part. Basically, there will be nothing will happen because the convention doesn't have a lot of funds, so the end result is nothing will happen. He did not recognize that, and I believe it is on record, so do correct me if I'm wrong, that he said on hindsight he did not realize that yun yung repercussion. Maybe he would realize it if you were there, Mr. Secretary. Yun yung point. Like, who's the best man, di ba? The best man should have been you, with all due respect.
Thank you for that confidence. But we were actually supporting SDES at that time. In fact, many of the suggestions were coming from our team, from the Department of Health.
It's like me sending my amazing female team of lawyers instead of me. I'm sure they will be like, fight kami, PSC. They call me PSC. Fight kami. Yeah, I'm sure. But iba pa rin yung impact kung ako yun. Alam mo na yun. Alam mo na yun. It's the same reason why I'm having a second meeting, because I need to see you eye to eye, face to face, because I need to hear it from you. So there is a difference.
Maybe for your confidence or trust, I was actually getting daily updates from the person beside me. I see Asik Albert was physically at the meeting, and he was sending me Viber messages. I was actually and explaining things that were happening in the meeting. So I was there in the battle virtually.
I also get from Dr. Domingo. He's very competent. Very competent. But let's not argue about this, no? Like I said, if hindi ka nag-attend nung TB, meron bang humaharang sa TB program? Wala. Dito may humaharang? Meron. Marami. So, that's what it is. Floor is still yours. What else do you want to add?
Yes. Well, I will not argue with you, Madam, for that, but TB was an opportunity that came, and I saw it as a judgment call, and I did get a lot of assistance and help. We got donations for additional drug-resistant TB meds, and also the chairmanship of that big international TB partnership, plus all the international agencies that are actually helping us in our fight in TB. So to me, it's a big success, and I think I can recover. I will be able to lead the next FCTC delegation of the Philippines still, and be able to push the anti-tobacco and the health dimension as well. Thank you, Madam.
Yeah, so the next question will answer my concerns